Subscribe our channel, press the bell icon for latest videos.
Hi friends, here in this video we are going to see the middle one-third rule, which is there for a rectangular section. So let's get started. First, I'll draw the rectangular cross section. So here I have drawn a cross section of a column, which is a rectangular cross section having width B and depth is D. Now middle one-third rule would be indicating an area at the center of this rectangle, and that area is the location for the eccentricity. That is, if we place the load anywhere in that area, we are going to get no tension in the section for this column. So I would be starting this middle third rule or middle one third rule by using the no tension condition, which is now this is the no tension condition, that is the eccentricity should be less than or equal to z upon a. And how this relation comes, for that you all can refer my video in which I had explained the no tension condition. Now at first I would be finding ex, that is the eccentricity with respect to x axis, and that would be zxx upon area. So here zxx is ixx upon y and divided by area. Ixx for a rectangular section is bd cube by 12. Then here it is divided by y. Y is, we have to see this x axis because we are taking the moment of inertia about this x axis, and it is cutting d, so y becomes d by 2. So here in the denominator we have d by 2, then divided by area, so that becomes, if I take the reciprocal, multiplied by 1 upon area, and area for this rectangular section is b into d, so that is b into d. Next, after the cancellation over here, d gets cancelled. Here there is d and d, that becomes d square. So d square gets cancelled. So d square would be cancelled here and d remains. Then b and b will get cancelled out. So we are getting only d by 6 here. So ex is less than or equal to d by 6. Now ex means eccentricity with respect to x axis. That is, we are measuring the distance from x axis. So when we measure it from the x axis onto one side, this distance is ex, which is d by 6. Similarly, from the x axis onto the other side, measuring the distance from the x axis, because eccentricity is with respect to x. Now here we get ex as d by 6, this ex is d by 6, addition of them becomes d by 3. Then similarly, I'll go for eccentricity with respect to y axis. So e suffix y, again no tension condition, it would be zyy upon area. Zyy is iyy upon y divided by area. Iyy for a rectangular section is db cube by 12 divided by y, and since we are taking the moment of inertia about the y axis, it is cutting this b, so y becomes b by 2. Then this division would be converted into multiplication if we take the reciprocal of area. So 1 upon a, and a is b into d. So here also, after the cancellations, b and b is b square. So b square gets cancelled, and in the numerator b remains. Then d and d will get cancelled out. So ey is less than or equal to b by 6. This is the eccentricity with respect to y axis. So measuring the distance from y on one side, it gives me ey. Similarly onto the other side, so ey is b by 6. B by 6 plus b by 6 becomes b by 3. So when I join all these points, here I am getting this area, and it means the meaning of this area is whenever inside this area, if we are placing the load or if we are placing it onto the boundary of this area, there will be no tension in the column. But the moment we move the load away from this area, anywhere outside it, it will result in tension in the section. So to avoid tension in the section which is not desired, we have to place the load in this region for a rectangular section, and that is nothing but the middle one-third rule. At the end, if you'll find my videos helpful, you can like, share, comment and subscribe our channel and share it amongst your family and friends. Thanks for watching.